that you saw moments ago standing in this ring in unity, bound together, holding Daniel Bryan up above their heads while he chanted, yes, yes, yes. And we've seen in social media all the speculation from all of you. What's going to happen? Are you going to be punished? Are you going to get fired? Well, let me just clarify right now. We have asked all of you to be here, stand on that stage for one simple reason tonight, and that is to say...
thank you. Thank you for taking matters into your own hands. Thank you for stepping up to the plate. Thank you for shining and grabbing that brass ring. And thank you for finally being men.
That's right. Thank you for finally stepping up. I know it had absolutely nothing to do with Daniel Bryan and the fact that Daniel Bryan was in this ring.
Come on, dude. The fact is, and I think I speak for everybody up here, we were fighting for Daniel Bryan. You screwed him over. You would do the same to us. We were only fighting for what's right.
Wow.
Right?
I find it hard to believe that all of you were fighting for Daniel Bryan. I've never known a WWE superstar that fought for a WWE champion. I always thought WWE superstars fought to be a WWE champion. Let me ask you, Dolph, is that how you feel? So let me get this straight. You were out here fighting for Daniel Bryan, who's had opportunity after opportunity that he has squandered at the WWE Championship. You were out here to fight for him, not to fight for you. So you're saying Daniel Bryan should get another opportunity at Battleground, an opportunity that, say, maybe Dolph Ziggler should have had at Battleground.
Or R-Truth. I mean, when's the last time you've had a championship match? I know I can't remember. Why shouldn't you be the face of the WWE? Or you, Zack Ryder. Woo-woo, you should be the face of the WWE. Well, I'll tell you what, there is one reason why you collectively do not have that championship opportunity as we speak this moment. And that reason is...
The Shield. I understand your frustration, guys, because the Shield has run roughshod on this place since the day they walked in the door. They have collectively beaten down each and every one of you on that stage. I can sense that frustration. I can sense that frustration among all of you. It has nothing to do with Daniel Bryan. Last week's show of unity had to do with frustration with the Shield. And I'm going to give you the opportunity to take that frustration out tonight. I am going to give all of you, Darren Young, Titus O'Neil, The Usos, Rob Van Dam, Dolph Ziggler, Kofi Kingston, Zack Ryder, R-Truth, Justin Gabriel, all of you are going to get the opportunity to take that frustration out tonight when you compete in an elimination handicap match against the Shield. And I'm going to give you a partner, hopefully a partner that will fight for you as hard as you supposedly fight for him. Your partner will be a gentleman that gets yet another shot at the WWE Championship at Battleground. He'll be a guy that feels he should be the face of the WWE. A man that feels he should be WWE Champion because, quite frankly, he feels he's better than all of you. Your partner tonight will be Daniel Bryan.
So there you have it, the first ever 11-on-3 handicap match, but that's not all. We wanted to say thank you to those men on this stage, but we also wanted to say thank you to the WWE Universe. So here's what we're gonna do tonight. All of you will have the opportunity to choose who will face Randy Orton right here in this ring tonight. Will it be R-Truth? WWE app, that's the exclusive place where you can vote. Because we believe in doing what is best for all of you.
Because after all, what's best for all of you is what's best for business.
Thank you.
What a startling decision by Triple H and Stephanie McMahon. First time ever. Monday Night Raw, an 11-on-3 handicap match, the Shield versus those who engage in an act of prejudice.
How does the Shield feel about this?
Yeah, I'm a little confused. It may be best for business, but is it best for the Shield? 11-on-3? Oh, man.
You're not the only one that looks confused. The Shield looks confused as well. Well, folks, we're still reeling after what happened 8 nights ago at Night of Champions. CM Punk finally getting his hands on Paul Heyman, part of that 2-on-1 handicap elimination match.
You're right. Not only is hands...